Vegeta is over here crushing rocks in ways that he never has before, Hakaiing them. It's funny, Beerus shows him how to do it with a rock, and then Vegeta tries again, but he does it with a rock about a tenth of the size that the one Beerus did it with. At the same time, Granola, when he's testing out his powers, he lifts up this massive rock, and he does a very similar thing to what Beerus did with that small rock. He makes the rock explode in a very similar way to a Hakai or a God of Destruction. He even says to himself, what kind of technique was that? Out of nowhere, we have a green-haired man wishing to become the most powerful of all time, and he gets it. He is naive, and he goes around telling people how he got this powerful. If you were suddenly the most powerful in the universe, you wouldn't tell someone that you wished to be that way. You would keep that a secret, but Granola tells people, and that's gonna get him killed. It's gonna make some people angry, especially the Saiyans. The first thing Granola does is he wants to find the whereabouts of Frieza. Where is Frieza? So he goes back to these space pirates and he beats them all up now that he's more powerful, and he asks, where is Frieza? This is the first time he reveals how he got as powerful as he did, and to me, that's dumb. You don't tell someone how you got that powerful, because if it's as easy as how you got that powerful, they could just do it themselves. He beats up everybody there, and they give in, and they say, alright, Granola, we don't know exactly where Frieza is, but we'll keep in touch, and we'll contact you as soon as we find out. Granola says, yeah, that's fine, whatever, but make it quick, I don't have much time to spare. And these guys are standing there thinking, what, you don't have much time? Doesn't your species live for 200 years? You've got another 150 years left. That is when it gets revealed that in order to get this powerful, Granola had to cut his life down to 3 years. He only has 3 years left to live. He wants to kill Frieza so bad that he cuts his own life down to 3 years. That's still enough time though. I mean, in 3 years, Oob is meant to be entering the world tournament, so they got plenty of time in 3 years. So Granola heads on out, and the captain, or the head of this space pirate group, is talking to everybody around the table, and he says, we don't want Granola to kill Frieza, because if Granola kills Frieza, there's nothing stopping him from overtaking his army and being the next Frieza. Granola has to die. And they all look at him and they think, that's impossible, Granola's now the strongest in the universe, how are we supposed to do that? That's when this 2000 IQ man says, we will use the Saiyans. Everybody around the table drops what they're doing and they say, those guys? You mean the two that took down Moro? Obviously they're talking about Goku and Vegeta. So it's cool, Goku and Vegeta's name has been thrust all around Universe 7. They are known around the universe now. That's cool. I think that's awesome. It then cuts to the top three. These are the most powerful in Universe 7 right now. Granola, Goku, and Vegeta. The power of a God of Destruction, the power of Ultra Instinct, and the power of Revenge. I have no idea how these space pirates are going to be getting in contact with Goku and Vegeta, but this guy says Granola has a grudge against the Saiyans, so he'll be itching to fight warriors from that tribe. I don't know who this guy is, but he knows his stuff, and that is where the chapter ends. It ends with a shot of the top three strongest in Universe 7. Fate will bring these three together, and when Goku and Vegeta, who have been training all their lives, find out about the new strongest in the universe and how he got that way, Goku and Vegeta have known about the Dragon Balls basically all their life, and they've never once ever thought about using them to make themselves stronger. So when they see Granola, this new guy who only has one goal on his mind, and the only way he could get it is by using cheat codes, it's setting up a pretty cool dynamic here. And cutting back to this guy, his name is Alek, and his whole logic by using the Saiyans that defeated Moro is that Granola may be the strongest in the universe, but if you put Goku and Vegeta up against him at the same time, it's a 2-on-1. Granola would be overwhelmed, and surely Goku and Vegeta would win. Unless your name is Broly, that's not happening. Granola's about to show up, and Vegeta and Goku are gonna take turns. Or maybe they'll be friends. Granola doesn't seem like that bad of a guy, but ever since he got that wish, he has seemed a little bit